Hello everyone, I'm Chris Williams and welcome to my special edition of my video blog, which today features footage from my recent holiday to the northwest of England. And in this first part of a two-part series, it's Liverpool. Right, so there you see the St. George's Hall opposite Liverpool Lime Street Station. Beautiful architecture in Liverpool, as I'm sure you'll know if you live there or if you've been there yourself. It was the European Capital of Culture in 2006, I think, if I remember right. Or it could be 2008. I know that in both of those years I went to go to Liverpool, but didn't get round to it. Of course, plenty of time on my hands at the moment, of course. I was able to arrange it, so it was really cheap to go and visit this wonderful city. I've read leaflets that say that the world is inside this city, and I think that's true. It would be nice to go and live there from a cultural point of view, but I'm not sure if there's any work opportunities. Now, of course, as you'll know, if you're a regular to my blogging, as you'll know, that I'm a fan of Liverpool Football Club, and indeed, that is one of the main reasons why I went on this trip to Liverpool. There is Anfield. This is the Kop end, of course. One set of famous gates, the other famous gates, of course, on the other side. This is going to go down, I think, as one of my most memorable life experiences. There is Bill Shankly. Of course, the museum, as you'll see later on, makes a big deal about Liverpool's history beyond Shankly. Here's a picture of me in the press conference room, although most of the time they use Melwood training ground for their press conferences. Now, I hope this man here in the orange t-shirt doesn't want royalties for this video, but he appears quite a lot of time, like just having to be behind him all the time. Right, so here we are inside the famous Anfield dressing room. That press conference room I was in a few moments ago, that used to be the book room in the old days under Shankly, and also under Dalglish for that matter. But Rafa Benitez tried to get a mini boot room in the back end of this changing room. Apparently Roy Hodgson didn't use it. There's the Lucas shirt, because all of the 2011 to 2012 shirts appear. Prior to the transfer window coming, of course. Here's Robbie the tour guide.
Ominous,
you
know, moving lightning, no
red at all, no chandeliers, very, very basic, very important. Now, if you look at that photo there, what I showed you before, you'll notice. You have to look at the Scouse accent, don't you? Now, I feel like I'm a Mac Day in this picture, but BBC back me. This is a famous This Is Anfield sign. And here's that man in the orange t-shirt again, he's in front of me again, and here's one of the highlights of going to Anfield. We're about to walk out and sit in the dugout. We've got sound effects turned on, so we feel like we're one of the Liverpool players. John Terry says in his autobiography that this moment on one of the European nights scared him. That was the European night where Liverpool beat Chelsea with that, if I remember rightly, that's the game with that controversial goal, where Mourinho said it wasn't the goal. But that could be Stamford Bridge, I have to double check that. Call myself a Liverpool fan, I'm sketchy on the club's history. But it doesn't matter. Fantastic stadium. Shame we can't get the grass at my family home, like this grass, cut a number of times a day, and they've got these special lighting tubes that they hold over to make it grow at a faster rate than conventional garden grass, because the more you cut it, the more spongier it becomes and more playable. They never show the roof at the stadium on the football coverage, so we just include that there. Step on the grass and you get thrown out of Anfield forever, they said. Trophy section in the museum, old, loads of old Big East replicas, is the FA Cup replica. And here is some of the most beautiful footage I have ever recorded on my digital camera. Don't know who this song is by, but nice tune, nice footage. I probably think it makes you feel dizzy. Lots of spin around action here. So, I'm going to be quiet for a few moments. I bet YouTube will flag up that this music is a copyright issue, because not my fault. They were playing it far too loud on the Megastore music system. Right, so let's enjoy this. Keeping up for when I bump into the Invisible Man. Happens sometime soon. Famous Albert Docks, where ITV used to film This Morning with Richard and Judy, and I believe it was here where Fred Talbot had that map of the UK. He fell off it once. Because I'm down here mainly for the brand new Museum of Liverpool. There's the famous Liver building. Because the first time I heard the term Liver was in relation to the rubbish Neris Hughes sitcom The Liver Birds. I could wind you up by including the theme tune to that in this video, but I don't think I will. And here's the River Mersey staring across at Birkenhead. Inspiration for Jerry and the Pacemakers' ferry across the Mersey. But we don't see any ferry in this footage. Just up from here there were some buskers who were trying to impersonate the Beatles for the tourists. Cardiff Bay tries to be like this, but it will never be like this. And there are some Beatles mannequins. And here's the hotel where I stayed. Discount hotel, £25 a night. Well, to be exact, it was £18 for the room and £7 for the buffet breakfast the next morning, because I had to go over there for the buffet breakfast, and also to pick up my card, which you're about to see me sticking in the door here. Here's my discount hotel room. It's a bunk bed, of course. I'm on my own, so I'm having this double bed all for myself. Someone had some anger management issues before I came here. I read reviews on the web before I came here. Some people said, oh, don't come here, it's like university accommodation. Well, indeed, it is like university accommodation. Reminds me of university, actually, but it's wonderful for me. This is what I'm used to from my university experiences, so I had no problem staying here. Strange that the light bulb is on the wall rather than the ceiling. Here's the view across to the Albert Docks. And, of course, reassuring for me that we've got Merseyside Police Headquarters opposite my window. You've got John Lewis up that way. Television in the room with a dubious selection of channels. Here's half of my breakfast the following morning. I think I had too many baked beans there. And, so it's now time to, leave Liverpool, back at Liverpool Street Station, waiting for the train off to Manchester. And you will see Manchester in episode 2 of this, video blogging series. I hope that you will, join me for that. But in the meantime, I have been Chris Williams. You can be my friend on Twitter, where I am Mrchrisalf2004, and I encourage you to check out my written blog, Mrchrisalf2004.blogspot.com. But until next time, it's bye for now. Bye bye.